Hello everyone, welcome back. I'm Lalit Singh. So we're going to continue our journey on background tasks. We have already learned about async tasks. We have learned about async task loader, background. We have talked about broadcast receivers also. So today we will talk about services. Now, before we go any further, I want to take an analogy here. Let's say you buy a laptop today and that after a couple of weeks, that laptop has stopped working. What would you do? Well, your first course of action would be call the customer care services and they will send an executive. And let's say they take your laptop to their company for a repair. Now, what exactly I want to get you from this is, during that, let's say they tell you after 5 days, your laptop will be returned. So during those 5 days, you are not going to the company and sitting or waiting there for your laptop to be getting repaired. Meanwhile, you can continue with your other tasks, which doesn't include laptop. So you can still eat, you can still sleep and all, right? You can still go to offices and do all the tasks which doesn't include your laptop. So that's what a service is. It runs in the background. After 5 days, when your laptop is repaired, it will they will give you back. So in the same way, in Android also, services is something which doesn't have any UI. It runs in the background. And once your service is completed, it gives you the result back. So in this particular session, we're going to talk about long tasks, how exactly you can run that in services, and what exactly is intent service. Of course, services is a very advanced and complex topic. There are many ways to configure services. So this lesson here is a very introductory part, but you can always go ahead and explore yourself and for the services. Well, let's just talk about services first. What exactly and how exactly you can implement the services in Android? Well, all the long-running tasks or any component which you think will be performing any long-running operation, you will be putting that in a background. What we have learned is you will be putting that in a background thread. Now, turns out you can use a component known as service instead of using directly a background thread. Well, your services still runs in the main thread, but it provides you a way that you can run your long running tasks inside it. So if I have to give you an example, whenever you are playing a music player, right, you are playing a music, you go to your music app, you play your music, and even if you close your application, or even if you are not no more interacting with your music player application, you are doing, let's say, browsing or any other application open up, your music is still playing in the background. So you see, your music doesn't need a UI to be present all the time to interact with your music player. So that's what a service is. It doesn't need any UI. It doesn't need any user interaction to interact with it, but it will run in the background. So what exactly services are good for? Well, all the network transaction or music players or input output file or any interaction with the content provider itself. Content provider is a way by which you can access the database or share the data between two applications. We'll talk about that in later sessions too. So let's just talk about the characteristics of services. Well, service is again a fundamental component, so it does need to be started with a intent. Like I discussed before, whenever you want to start any fundamental component activity, broadcast receiver, services, they all will be started with a intent. So you need to call it, you need to initialize an intent to call your services. And with the help of using services, you can always switch between the application and your work doesn't get affected because your work is running in a service. So it doesn't need a UI or it doesn't need a user to all the time present or the activity. Activities needs a UI. Activity needs the user to interact with them to operate. Let's say you are filling up a form. It needs the user. It needs the screen on the screen. It needs that activity layout to be present on the screen. But services doesn't need that. Of course, your services also have a lifecycle. We're going to discuss about that. And it runs on your main thread. So you have to be very careful that whatever the operation you are putting in your services that are not taking too long. Of course, there is, services are used for long running tasks, but it shouldn't take that long also. it's really halting your main thread, because ultimately your services are running on your main thread. But if you do find that any task which is taking a lot of time, then you can always, inside the services itself, you can always put a background thread and or a worker thread, and it will be you will be able to run your services as smoothly as you were running your async tasks or any other background thread. So when we talk about services, there are two types of services. One, started services. Second, bound services. Okay, the first form of service is started services. Now, a started services will be always called with a method named start service. Once you call this method, your started service will start executing. A start service, when execute, it runs indefinitely. It's the user who needs to put the code to stop that service. You can stop your service by calling stop service, or there will be a code that is called self stop. It runs indefinitely until and unless stop itself, right? So, and it will not update your UI. So how exactly the life cycle of start service looks like? It will always start from on create. On create will be called just once, and then there will be on start command method. It will get called as soon as somebody calls for the start service. This is the method where you want to put your functionality, what you want to do in your service. This is, inside this method, you will put that functionality. If that task is taking too long, you can put that in a background thread or worker thread also. After that, once your task is done, the destroying lifecycle is you just call on destroy method, and it will be out of the memory. Please be apprised that once you start a started service, and after that you again try to start that, it will not create a new object. It will just run that same object which was already started before. Okay, next form of services is bound services. Well, bound services provide you a client-server interface, and that too, it's a server-side. Bound services are implemented as server-side, which allow the components to interact with the services. Your client can send requests to you or request to the service and get the result back. You can always start a bind service by calling a method named bind service. Start service, it gets called by start service. Bound services gets called by bind service. And your bound service will not get destroyed until unless all the clients are unbinded through it, unbinded from it. Let's say there are 10 clients using that bound service. One client, goes away. One client unbinds itself. Still, your service will not get destroyed. Of course, your service has stored for that particular client, but still there are 9 users. Let's say all the 9 users unbinds from that service, then only your bound service gets destroyed. How and what exactly is the lifecycle of bound service? Well, it starts from on create itself, but this time instead of on start command, it will be binding the components, binding the clients on a method named on bind. And once it binds to the component, this is where you will put the functionality, fetching or getting the request, returning back the result. And anybody who wants to unbind, they have to call on unbind method. And after that, you can destroy, if each and every component or each and every client is unbinded, then on destroy method will be called and your lifecycle or your services get destroyed. Okay, so let's just talk about services and threads now. Well, services, although it's separate from your UI, but they still run on your main thread instead of your intent service. We will talk about that in a bit. So they run on your main thread. So you cannot put any, high CPU intensive work on your service itself. If you think that it is going to take much more time, then offload that CPU intensive work to a separate thread. Of course, within a service, you can just call a separate thread and you can put that high or long running task in that particular thread. I know service cannot update the app because service can't access the UI thread. So how do I update my UI then with the help of service? Well, I use broadcast receivers inside the services to update my UI. So every time I want to update something, I will just call a broadcast receiver, and broadcast receiver in turn will update my UI in my activity. if I want to update the UI from the services. So what are foreground services? Let's just talk about foreground services. Well, foreground services still runs in the background only, but they require the user awareness. Well, for example, music player or downloading a file. Why exactly I'm saying that they require a user awareness? You must have seen when you play a music, when you go to your music player and you start playing your music, and even if you have close your activity for music player, your music is still playing. Your music is still playing in the background. Your service is still running. You drag down your notification bar. You can see the music player notification there, and you cannot just clear that notification. You have to stop your service first, then only you can stop that notification. In the same way, let's say you are downloading a file. After that, you no more require that activity. You can go and switch between other applications, but your application or your file is getting downloaded in the background. So in the notification, you can see a notification that your file is getting downloaded. You cannot just remove that notification until the user has provided the option to delete that or cancel that. So you are aware about that service, that it is running in the background. So, but it's in service, right? So it has a high priority. It has a high priority than your activity. First priority will always be given to the activity because it is the thing which is user is seeing. Second are given to the foreground services. They are still running in the background, but user is more aware about them. Then there are background services. Background services are like which user is not aware about, but they are still running in the background. Maybe changing a wallpaper is something, a service which is running in the background. User is not aware, but yeah, they are running in the background. So whenever you are implementing a foreground service, user need to provide a notification which the user cannot dismiss while service is running. You have to stop your service, then only you will be able to dismiss your notification. So how do you create a service? Well, as service is a fundamental component, you do need to initialize and declare it in your manifest file with the help of a tag service and give the service name. And you can always provide the permission who can use your services, who cannot use your services. You can even, then you need to create a class which will be extending either service class or intent service, which we will see. And then implement the lifecycle method and start the service from your main activity. That is, if you are using a started service, you will start it with the help of start service method. Or if you are using bind service, it will be started with bind service method. So how do we stop services? Well, let's just talk about first type of service, started services. Started services manages their its own lifecycle, and you have to stop them once they are done with that task which they are supposed to do, because they run indefinitely, if you are not stopping them, they will keep on consuming your resources. So the way to stop them itself is by calling stop self, or another component, or any other component can also stop them. You can provide a button, and then just inside the functionality or on click of that button, just put stop service. Then also that services get stopped. Bound services get destroyed when all the clients get unbounded from it. Until unless there is only even a one client, your bound services will not get destroyed, right? Intent service will get destroyed after you are finished with on handle intent returns, right? We will just talk about it, but know that there is an intent service also which will be getting destroyed once you are finished with this method on handle intent. This is where you put the functionality, and once it returns something to you, your service will get destroyed. So let's just talk about intent service now. In intent service, they have a very simplified lifecycle. You don't have to worry about all those on create, on start command. Well, under the hood, they are implementing it, but a user doesn't need to know about all those complex lifecycle now. They uses the worker thread behind the scene to run all the long running tasks in the background thread. And you don't even have to worry about stopping the service. It does it for you. I mean, once the task is done, it stops itself. So what is the limitation of using intent services? Well, Of course, they cannot interact with UI. Again, you have to use a mechanism of broadcast receiver to interact with UI. They can only handle one request at a time. So if let's say you are downloading 10 files, you have just given a request of downloading 10 files. First file will be downloaded, then the second one, then the third one. You can't just do the multi-threading right away inside the intent service. If you need that, then you have to explicitly put the code here. And cannot be interrupted. If you're interrupted, you might have to do the same thing from the very starting. So how can you implement the intent service? So you will create a class, my own service, and extend it with intent service. And if you want to provide a constructor, you provide a constructor. But the main thing here is you need to override this method that is known as onHandleIntent. This is where you will put the code, what you want to do in your service, and it will be running in a background thread or a worker thread. So you will put the code, and once you are done, and then you will be, if you want to return something, you will return. And once this whole method is executed, your service will get destroyed on its own. So to learn more about services and background services, you can follow the following links. Next, we're going to see the concept in Gitbook, and we are going to see, there is no practical in the Gitbook, but we are going to see a small demo of the service. So let's just get to it. Thank you.